Sorry for the delay. There are some issues with the sharing screen. Thanks to the Trichy Urology True Foundation and Dr. Vineet for giving me an opportunity to talk about simultaneous bilateral endoscopic surgery. We know that urolithiasis is a common and recurrent ailment increasing in prevalence worldwide. And we also know that the incidence of bilateral urolithiasis is on the increase, and roughly around 15% of patients are present with bilateral renal stones. So the treatment challenges and goals include reducing the morbidity and minimizing the cost, especially in third world countries. Bilateral same session surgeries for kidney stones has been many advantages, like single anesthesia, shorter hospitalization time, early return to work, less X-ray exposure, and overall cost effectiveness. And there are many studies that have proven the safety and feasibility of bilateral procedures. Bilateral non-simultaneous procedures include RIRS, PCNL, URSL, and flexible URS. These studies have shown good results, and the complication rates are in par with single-stage treatments. However, there's the concept of two surgeons operating in tandem, each of them operating a different side of the urinary system, is quite new and is the definition for simultaneous bilateral endoscopic surgery. One of the first series was reported by Chung et al., who performed the bilateral simultaneous RIRS in 2006, but due to the technical issues and having two scopes going at the same time, it never took up. But Dr. Guisti et al. From Italy described a technique whereby two surgeons have worked simultaneously, combining supine PCNL and flexible URS in tandem fashion, with one surgeon performing PCNL and the other surgeon performing flexible URS on the contralateral side. This is the publication made by them and their results, which is good in the European Journal of Urology, and it gives a good description on how the technical aspects and the advantages of doing it. And this is a diagram I borrowed from that journal, which shows how to position the patient. So the patient is positioned in a supine PCNL position. And you can see that you have there are two monitors. There is a screen one for the surgeon performing the PCNL, and there's a screen two for the person performing the flexible URS. And then you have a screen three, which is more or less the C-arm screen. And you can perform two procedures at the same time in this sort of an arrangement. And what did they observe from the study was that both the procedures were completed at the same time, further shortening the anesthetic and operative times. There are favorable outcomes in terms of stone-free rates and complication rates. They did measure the GFR of the kidneys, and they found that there was no increased risk of acute renal failure. There was no any undue requirement for blood transfusions. In fact, in the study, they had no requirement for blood transfusions. And they inferred that the ideal candidates are patients with bilateral small to medium-sized stones who have a high chance of becoming stone-free in one session and are unlikely to undergo a second surgery. Encouraged by this, a lot of centers performed a multicentric trial on simultaneous bilateral endoscopic surgery. And you can see the publication by Prof. Orio Longari. And they inferred that simultaneous and synchronous bilateral endourological surgery for stone disease appeared to be a feasible and safe procedure. It had comparable outcomes with bilateral same session and unilateral surgical series, while potentially reducing the operative time and the patient inconvenience of having multiple stage procedures. We have our own set of patients, which we did in Chennai, and we have a total of around 12 patients. We performed a PCNL with a contralateral rigid URS in 6 patients and contralateral flexible URS in 6 patients. We had 8 male and 4 female patients. The mean size of stone on the PCNL side was about 2.4 centimeters and on the URS side about 1.1 centimeters. And stone-free rates were nearly 90%, and we didn't have any significant complications in our series. This is a patient who had a lower ureteric stone on one side and a renal stone on the lower pole on the opposite side. This is one of our patients who underwent bilateral endoscopic surgery. This is another patient who had calyceal stones on one side and a complex staghorn on one side, again underwent bilateral endoscopic surgery. And this another patient with again a mid-urethric large stone with one small renal stone and a complex lower pole staghorn on the opposite side. These are a subset of patients who underwent simultaneous bilateral endoscopic surgery in our series. This is how we position our patients, just to show how to position. There's a typical positioning on which we do it in for supine PCNL. We just keep two bolsters, one below the hip and one at the shoulder joint level. Keep one side slightly fixed and the other leg on lithotomy. And this position, you are ready to go for a simultaneous procedure. In this position, it's more than adequate. Just like the same position what we use for a supine PCNL. This is a picture of how we do it. This is one of my good friends, Dr. Venkat, who is doing the rigid ureteroscopy on one side. And you can see that he is observing the monitor from his end, and I am performing the mini PCNL from one side, and we have a C-arm. And you don't need many people, to just one nurse would be enough to help you with the instruments, and you'll be able to finish both the procedures in one go, and definitely it reduces the operative times. Just to show an idea on how the things we push in on our hospital. Another view of us, both of us doing the procedure. The only thing is that you need two experienced surgeons, and you have to be you have two people, the experienced surgeons, to do this procedure at the same time. Otherwise, the time taken is fairly short. This is a small video of both of us performing a simultaneous bilateral endoscopic procedure. And this is me performing the supine PCNL from my end, looking at the monitor, and my good friend Dr. Venkat performing a rigid URS, which will be later converted to a flexible URS. And he's using a lithoclast for the lower uretric bit, and I am using a laser. You could see that both of us are doing the procedure. So from our experience, we thought that the SBES, or the simultaneous bilateral endoscopic surgery definition, should include a tandem PCNL with either rigid or flexible URS. Because Dr. Christie's paper shows only as a flexible URS, I think both rigid and flexi URS should include a definition of SBES. It definitely reduces the OR times, cost, and allows patient early return to work. It has comparable stone-free rates with no increased rate of complications. The potential hurdles that we may face is we need a spacious OR with adequate personnel, two sets of monitor stacks, two energy sources, and two experienced doctors to perform this procedure. Otherwise, it's quite straightforward and easy. It's a key that both the surgeons should complement each other and should help each other while performing and not try to disturb each other. And always believe that two are better than one because they have a good reward for their labor. Thank you.
Thanks, Arun. Thank you very, very much for a very compact and a very precise presentation. There's a question from another platform, and they ask, do you think only general anesthesia is mandatory, or epidural and spinal is good enough?
Yeah, we have a fairly large series of patients with spinal anesthesia. It's more than enough to perform simultaneous bilateral surgeries. But the only thing is, we don't want any movements because we are doing both the kidneys. So I think a GA would be preferred in these situations rather than a spinal anesthesia.
And do you think it's best to pre-stent these patients?
We haven't pre-stented because most of our cases, if we don't try to get or if we are not able to get a rigid URS or a flexible URS, then we stent the patient and bring him for a second sitting.
All right. And the last question is the post-op pain more than on patient because you do it both sides?
I don't think so. The patients are absolutely comfortable, and it's just like any other procedures. I don't think there's any added pain or any added discomfort because of this.
The same gentleman from Mexico is asking, do you think the patient has to be, can it be done as a 23-hour day surgery?
Well, Yes, I think so. I don't think why we shouldn't do it as a daycare procedure because we are doing the PCNLs as daycare procedures as and we do discharge them within 23 hours. And just adding a URS on the opposite side, I don't think adds any risk for that mandates keeping the patient inside the hospital.
Thank you so much for answering all the questions. And with that, we...